Alleluia, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Let us pray. Almighty God, who through Jesus Christ overcame death and opened to us the gate of everlasting life, grant that we, who celebrate with joy the day of the Lord's resurrection, may be raised to the new life of grace in the power of your Holy Spirit. Amen.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father, but go to my brothers and say to them, 'I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God.'" Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her. The Gospel of the Lord.
After months and months, if not years, of feeling unsafe and threatened, and feeling worried about the security of her family and friends, she was completely exhausted. We can all relate to Mary Magdalene in feeling worn out after going through a trauma. Mary Magdalene's worst nightmare came true, though, when she learned that her beloved teacher and friend, Jesus, had been arrested, convicted, and sentenced to be tortured and to die upon a cross. Her whole group of companions were thrown into terror over this news, and others in the group became so afraid that they fled the scene, unable to stay present with Jesus because they were so fearful that they too would be targeted and arrested. Somehow, Mary Magdalene and some others were able to have the courage and the strength to stay present with Jesus and to accompany him through all the ordeal that he went through. In fact, scripture tells us that Mary Magdalene and a group of women huddled near the foot of the cross so that Jesus could lay eyes on them and take comfort, knowing that he was not alone, even as he was dying. It was Mary Magdalene, along with some others, who watched Jesus die and then laid his body in a tomb. But because the Sabbath was starting, Mary was prohibited from properly preparing the body by anointing Jesus' body with spices. And so she had to put that off until another day. Early on Sunday morning, she got up at dawn and she gathered all the supplies, the spices and ointments that she would need. And she went back to the tomb where they had left Jesus's body. And when she got there, she was shocked because Jesus's body was not where they had left it. Looking around the room frantically, wondering what had happened, feeling confused, all of a sudden, she saw someone. She felt a presence. And she wasn't sure, was this the gardener? Was this an angel? Until that presence spoke to her and said her name. "Mary," said the person, "why are you weeping?" And immediately her eyes were open and she recognized that it was Jesus raised from the dead. And she cried out, "Rabbi." Jesus asked her, "Mary, go and tell the others that I am raised from the dead. Proclaim the good news." Mary's heart was pounding as she had this secret to tell, this eyewitness account of the resurrected Christ. And as she rushed to find her companions and tell them the good news, she was filled with hope. We call Mary Magdalene the apostle to the apostles, the first evangelist, proclaiming the good news of Jesus' resurrection to the world. Jesus appeared at other times to other disciples, but Mary Magdalene was the first to experience and be an eyewitness to the resurrection of Christ. And she was the first to proclaim that good news. Through the ages, Mary's story has been passed from person to person and from generation to generation, so that good news of the resurrection not only changed Mary's life and the lives of the disciples and followers of Jesus, but ultimately that story had the power to change the world. And so we receive that legacy. We give thanks that Mary Magdalene was an eyewitness and that she was willing to be present to the resurrection and to recognize it and to share that good news passed on to us. And now that responsibility for proclaiming the good news rests on us today. We give thanks that God did something extraordinary by raising Jesus from the dead and unleashing God's love and the Holy Spirit into the world in a new transforming way through the power of the resurrection. We give thanks for Mary Magdalene and her eyewitness account and her proclamation of the good news. And today we give thanks that we have an opportunity to be proclaimers of that same good news. And we do that by opening ourselves to noticing what's going on in the world around us and in ourselves. Because we have faith, we see that when new life is happening, we see that that is because of the power of Jesus Christ and the resurrection. We noticed that when people are sometimes dying, that is not the final answer, that life always wins, even in the midst of death, that new life springs out one way or another. We see healing happening in other people, in ourselves. We see transformation happening in ourselves and in our relationships. And we know, we have a gut sense that that is the resurrected Christ working in us to make us more forgiving, more forgiven, more merciful, more compassionate. We are eyewitnesses to whole cultures being changed and transformed to become more just, more merciful, more compassionate. And we attribute that to the power of God and to the resurrection of Jesus. And so today, I wish you a happy Easter, and I invite you to proclaim with me, He is risen. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father draw them, and I will raise them up, and I will raise them up, and I will raise them up on the last day.
Let us pray to God,
who hears our prayers and has compassion
for the hungry and the overfed.
May we have enough
for the mourners and the mockers.
May we laugh together
for the victims and the oppressors.
May we share power wisely
for the peacemakers and the warmongers.
May clear truth and stern love lead us to harmony.
For the silenced and the outspoken.
May we speak our own words in truth.
For the unemployed and the overworked.
May our impact on others be kindly and creative.
For the troubled and the content.
May we live together as wounded healers.
For the homeless and the comfortable.
May our homes be simple, warm, and welcoming.
For the vibrant and the dying.
May we all trust in your love.
For the many blessings in our lives.
May we give thanks and become more generous.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us pray. Dear Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to possess you within my soul. And since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I beseech you to come spiritually into my heart. I unite myself to you, together with all your faithful people, gathered around every altar of your church, and I embrace you with all the affections of my soul. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
On behalf of the congregation of Old St. Paul's, Baltimore, we wish you a very happy Easter, filled with hope for new life and the power of Christ's resurrection. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. And the blessing of God be with you this day and remain with you always. Go in peace, rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.